हाय एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू एडियोलियो। सो आज हम इस वीडियो में आपके जूलियस सीजर के एक्ट वन सीन वन के क्वेश्चन आंसर्स डिस्कस करेंगे जो कि आपकी वर्कबुक के हैं ICSE बोर्ड के। सो लेट स्टार्ट विद फर्स्ट MCQ। हाउ डज फ्लेवियस डिस्क्राइब द कॉमनर्स? सो द आंसर इज ए, फ्लेवियस कैरेक्टराइजेज द कॉमनर एज आइडल क्रिएचर्स। नाउ सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, वॉट इज द प्रोफेशन ऑफ द सेकेंड सिटीजन? नाउ द आंसर इज बी, द सेकेंड सिटीजन इज अ कॉबलर। ठीक है, देन मूव टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, हाउ डज मेरुलस एड्रेस द सिटीजन्स? नाउ द आंसर इज आंसर डी, मेरुलस एड्रेसेस द सिटीजन्स एज ब्लॉक्स स्टोन्स एंड वॉर्स देन सेंसलेस थिंग्स। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, वॉट डू द कॉमनर्स नीड टू डू टू इंटरमिट द प्लेग अकॉर्डिंग टू मेरुलस? नाउ द आंसर इज सी, मेरुलस इंस्ट्रक्ट्स द कॉमनर्स टू वीप देयर टीयर्स इनटू द रिवर। क्वेश्चन 5, टू वॉट एनिमल इज सीजर कंपेयर्ड इन द टेक्स्ट? नाउ द आंसर इज ए, सीजर इज कंपेयर्ड टू अ लॉयन। ठीक है, नाउ मूव टू कॉन्टेक्स्ट क्वेश्चंस। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, नाउ द आंसर ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्ट इज, फ्लेवियस एंड मेरुलस आर ट्रिब्यून्स प्रेजेंट ऑन अ स्ट्रीट इन रोम। दे सी पीपल गैदर्ड इन देयर बेस्ट क्लॉथ्स सेलिब्रेटिंग सीजर्स विक्ट्री। द ट्रिब्यून्स आर कंसर्न्ड अबाउट सीजर्स इंक्रीजिंग पॉपुलरिटी एंड हेंस आर डिस्पर्सिंग द क्राउड। नाउ सेकेंड आंसर इज, द कॉमनर्स इन द सीन आर नॉट ड्रेस्ड इन देयर यूजुअल अटायर विच वुड इंक्लूड टूल्स ऑफ देयर ट्रेड, इंस्टेड दे आर ड्रेस्ड इन देयर बेस्ट क्लॉथ्स। नाउ द थर्ड इज, ए पार्ट इज, दे आर मैनुअल वर्कर्स। सेकेंड बी इज, इट इज़ नॉट अ यूजुअल वर्किंग डे। सी इज, दे आर नॉट वेयरिंग देयर वर्किंग क्लॉथ्स दैट वुड हैव टूल्स ऑफ देयर प्रोफेशन सच एज लेदर एप्रंस और रोल्स। Now the fourth part, the second citizen identifies himself as cobbler. When confronted, he retorts and calls the man a rascal. Now the fifth part, Flavius seeks to know the trade of the first citizen. Merulus then questions this citizen about the absence of his tools. The interaction indicates that Flavius and Merulus hold a position of authority. They are displeased with the citizens for celebrating Caesar's victory and insist and quelling Caesar's growing popularity. Now question number 2, first answer is, the cobbler plays on words suggesting he is a mender of souls, indicating he repairs shoes and perhaps touches on the human soul. Now second answer, the pun is on the words mender of souls, implying he mends shoes and also possibly mends human souls. Now the third answer is, the cobbler suggests that he conducts his trade with a clear conscience and doesn't deceive people. Now fourth answer, expressions like thou, saucy fellow and blocks reflect the official's disdain for artisans. They refer to common people with less respect using terms like vulgar. Now fifth answer, the citizens wear signs of their trade which helps in identifying their professions. The citizens have recently celebrated Pompey's victory, have now gathered to celebrate Caesar's triumph. This indicates their fickle nature. Now question number 3, first answer, the commoners who once celebrated Pompey's victory have now gathered to rejoice over Caesar's triumph over Pompey's sons. Now second answer, the fickleness of the commoners is evident. They once celebrated Pompey's victory with enthusiasm and later with the same fervor they celebrated his defeat. This suggests that they need to show gratitude and loyalty consistently. Now third answer, Julius Caesar's victory over Pompey's son was not a conquest of a foreign land, but a triumph over a faction within the same country. Thus no new territory came under Rome. Now fourth answer, the vanquished were not burdened with taxes or fines, and there were not any prisoners tied with chains to Caesar's chariot, indicating respect shown to the conquered. Now fifth part, the common people celebrated both Pompey's victory and later Julius Caesar's victory over Pompey's sons. This inconsistent behavior shows them as being cruel. Now the fourth part, first answer, when Pompey emerged victorious, the sound of the cheers was so loud and unanimous that even the river felt its vibration. Second answer, their cheering was intense to that extent that its echo could be felt at the Tiber River, and the river trembled due to its vibration. Now the third answer, Pompey's sons met with a tragic end, their blood being shed. Now Julius Caesar celebrates his victory, having triumphed over them. Fourth answer, on special occasions, they wear their finest cloths and treat the day लाइक अ फेस्टिव सेलिब्रेशन स्कैटरिंग फ्लावर्स ऑन सीजर्स पाथ एज अ मार्क ऑफ रेस्पेक्ट एंड सेलिब्रेशन। नाउ फिफ्थ आंसर, द स्पीकर वॉन्ट्स टू ड्रॉ अटेंशन टू द क्राउड्स इनकन्सिस्टेंसी एंड इम्पल्सिव बिहेवियर बाय पॉइंटिंग आउट देयर टफथुलनेस एंड फिकलनेस। ही एम्स टू मेक देम रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन देयर एक्शंस एंड परहैप्स फील रिमोर्स फॉर देयर इजली स्वेड लॉयल्टीज। Now fifth question, first part, the reason for removing the decorations from Caesar's status was to dampen the festive mood that was prevailing after Caesar's victory over Pompey's sons. Now second part, the feast of Lupercal was celebrated in honor of the god Lupercus, believed to be the protector of sheep and goats. During this feast, young men would run through the streets and touch spectators with leather straps. It was a popular belief that women, especially those who couldn't conceive, would be cured of their infertility when touched with these straps. Now third part, the statues adorned with trophies symbolize Caesar's triumphs and achievement. When Flavius mentions suppressing enthusiasm for Caesar by removing these decorations, he compares it to pulling feathers from a bird. Without these feathers, the bird will not soar high. Similarly, without the recognition and constant adulation, Caesar's image will not soar among the commoners. The fourth part, the commoners consisting of workers and artisans are described as fickle because of their changeable nature. One day they celebrated Pompey and on another they celebrated Caesar's victory over him. There is a concern that if their enthusiasm is not checked, they might soon elevate Caesar to the position of a king. The term fickleness of the crowd in the critical comments section likely delves into the unpredictable and inconsistent nature of the masses, often swayed by the changing tides of power and influence. So this is all about this chapter in this video. If you have enjoyed this video, just make sure to like the video and subscribe our channel. Thanks.